Bells, Max Bells, Speed, Distribution Law. This is what we are doing since the last class or before last class. Yeah, still someone is waiting. Okay. This is what we are doing since the last two classes. See, we got one equation in the previous class. That means a solution to one equation. In all, we got three equations in the previous class. All are almost similar. Okay, each equation refers to the motion of a gas molecule in one particular direction. Okay, since we are taking a box, okay, which is spread along the x, y, z axis, now all our molecules are having all the three components. Okay, we are writing one equation for each velocity component of the molecule. See, our molecule is having u velocity along x axis. The same molecule is having v velocity along y axis. The same molecule is having w velocity along z axis. So we are having three equations referring to the motion along each axis. Okay, what are those equations we wrote in the previous class? Okay, just you take a piece of paper and try to write down all these equations. Because time to time I'm erasing all these equations because we don't have that much space here in the whiteboard. See, this is the first equation. It du, this is what du. It refers to the motion along x-axis. Next, f prime v. V is the velocity along y axis. F prime v by f v plus lambda v dv is equal to 0. Now you may easily guess what will be the third equation. The form of the equation is same, but the velocity is different. W here, the velocity component is w, so we are getting f prime of w by f w plus lambda w dw is equal to 0. What we have done in the previous class is we solved this first equation, isn't it? We solved this first equation after removing this bracket and multiplying the each term with this du. Okay, see, this is the equation in u. Okay, this is the equation, this is the equation in u. Variable is u. So r, u r f of u. Okay, f prime u by f u, we are having this now. So we are going to get the solution as f u is equal to something. What we got in the previous class, that means after doing integration. Okay, there are two terms in this equation. Write one term on the one side of the is equal to sign. Write other term on the other side of the equal to sign. What we have done in the previous class, and take integrals on both sides, then do the integration, then finally you are going to get, okay, the solution for the first equation as C. This is the equation in FU. That's why we are getting the answer for FU, which we got in the previous class as A e power minus lambda u square by lambda u square by 2. Okay, this is what the solution of the first equation, this equation in u or in fu. Okay, here a is a constant, but here lambda by 2 is also a constant. Therefore, I am writing this equation as f of u is equal to a minus of, instead of lambda by 2, I am writing some other constant. Why? Because lambda is a constant and 2 is also a constant, minus of b u square. See, now it looks very much simple, but you have to understand that b is how much. Okay, here what is our b? B is lambda by 2. We denoted this lambda by 2 with the letter B. Okay, so that this solution looks very simple. Okay, now here A and B are constants. What is the solution? This fu is equal to AA e to the power of minus B u square. This is the solution for the motion along the x-axis. Okay, right. A e power minus B u square. See, now without solving this equation 2 and equation 3, you can guess the solutions. Why? Because all these three equations are in the exactly similar form. Okay, now I am erasing this part. I am writing the solutions for this equation and this equation without doing any work. Why? Because I am guessing based on the previous solution. What is the difference between this equation and this equation? The difference is only in variable. The form of the equation is exactly similar. Instead of having V, you are having W. Okay, in the previous equation, you had U. Instead of V, you had U. So, now you guess the solutions for these last two equations. You are going to have F of V. That is equal to A. Okay. E power minus B, here you are having U square, here you will be having V square. Why? Because it is FV. So simply we wrote the equation for the second equation, differential equation. Next, write the solution for this third equation. F of W is equal to, what will be the solution? Without doing anything, you may simply write the solution. A e power minus B, instead of V square, now you are going to have W square. So, now we solved all these three equations describing the motion of the gas molecules in X, Y and Z axis respectively. Okay, if you have done up to this part, so majority of the derivation will be over. Okay, you are on the safe side. Okay, now we are just manipulating the equation. Right, now actually in the probability you are having fu, fv, fw. Okay, what is the probability? Probability is given by fu, fv, fw. Okay, whenever you are multiplying these three functions with the three velocities, du, dv, dw, that will be the total probability. Okay, before going to write the total probability, I am just trying to find the product of these three solutions. What is the motive for doing the product? That product is there in the probability of finding the particle or the molecule, okay, in the velocity limits u and u plus duv and v plus dv and w and d plus dw in x, y, z axis respectively. So, after finding three solutions, I am multiplying them. Okay, there is no magic. See, okay, you write down all these things neatly on a white paper. Fu, Fv, Fw. Now, I want this product. Okay, I am multiplying the LHS values. Now, we have to multiply the RHS values. Otherwise, you just substitute the value of Fu, Fu, Fv and Fw. What is fu? A e power minus b u square into. What is fv? A e power minus b v square into. What is fw? A e power minus b w square. Okay, I am just substituting the values of fu, fv and fw. Okay, now I am erasing these functions. Now, you just try to, I am erasing these functions as well. Just I am keeping the product. Right. Now, you simplify this RHS. What is LHS, FU, FV and FW? The product of these velocity functions is now A into A into A is A cube. Okay. Next, e power minus bu square into e power minus bv square into e power minus bw square is e power. Whenever you are having e power x into e power y into e power z, then what will be the answer? E power x plus y plus z. You have to sum the exponents. Here also I am going to sum the exponents. Minus bu square minus bv square minus bw square. Isn't it? This product. This is equal to a cube e power. Here you may take this b minus. Okay, see, I am saying that I am adding them up, but I am writing minus signs. Why? Why? Because plus of minus bv square means minus bv square. Plus of minus bw square is minus bw square. Why? Because plus into minus is minus. Okay. Right. Now, here you are having b common in these three terms in the exponential. Okay, including minus. Okay, minus b is common. Now, what you are going to have inside the brackets? U square plus v square plus w square. But what is u square plus v square plus w square? Since here I am writing, since u square plus v square plus w square, c is the total velocity, u, v, w are the component velocity along x, y, z axis is respectively. Okay. So now you may substitute here c square. You may substitute here c square. Simply you may substitute here c square. Otherwise, you may just keep it as it is for now. Later on, we will write here u square plus v square plus w square is equal to c square. We know that. But what is this? This is a product of fu, fv and w. Fw. What is its value? A cube e power minus b u square plus b square plus w square. But actually, what is the formula for the total probability of finding the particle whose velocity along x direction in between the limits u and u plus du and velocity along y direction is in between the limits v plus dv and whose velocity along z axis is in between the limits w and d plus w, dw, that probability is given by, you know that, fu, fv and fw into du, dv, dw. So, what I am going to do now, I am multiplying this product with du, dv, dw. Okay. You take the fu, fv, fw value from this equation previous step. So, here probability is given by, in the place of fu, fv, fw, I am writing this thing, a cube e power minus b, okay, u square plus v square plus w square. Okay, in the place of fu, fv, fw, I am writing this into, we are having du, dv, dw. So, this is what the expression for the, total probability, fu, fv, fw into du, dv, dw is equal to this much. Okay, that is the total probability. But here, if you want to know the value of these A and B's, see, this will not be the complete solution. Why? Because constants are there. Now, you got the expression for probability, but you don't know A B values. Okay. Now, you know that from the probability in the mathematics, what is the total probability for anything? Okay. What is the value of total probability? Total probability is always 100% or 1. Okay. So, whenever you integrate this probability, okay, then what happens? that becomes equal to 1. So whenever you integrate this probability, okay, then what happens? Total probability is 1. Okay, here you are having the limits du dv dw. So you write down this entire equation here. Okay, again you need not to write the integral variables. So whenever you take integration for this probability, that value should be 1. That value should be 1. Okay, so here again you take a cube e power minus b u square, this is a cube u square plus b square plus w square du dv dw is equal to how much? 1. Okay, from this probability principle you may evaluate these a and b values. Okay, so now what we are going to do here, we are going to find the unknown a and b values from the probability principle. What is that probability principle? Total probability, okay, is 1. Total probability of any system is 1. Okay, any outcome is 1. Right. Now, see, here you may split these things into 3 exponential functions. Okay. See here, integral. I am taking 3 integrals because here you are taking the motion along 3 axes. So you may now, you take this a cube outside. Why? Because, okay, the functions are only the exponential functions. Now you may split these things. E power minus b u square into e power minus b v square into e power minus b w square, because earlier we had the similar equation. In the simplification we added all the exponentials. Okay, but now I am again splitting here in order to find a b values. Okay, du dv dw, this is equal to 1, just now we wrote. See, here you may find these integrals individually. This integral with du, this integral e power minus bv square into dv, again this last integral into e power minus b omega square into dw. That means 3 linear integrals are there. All are in a similar form. By making use of one formula, I am trying to find the values of all the 3 integrals. See, you remember one general formula. Here, what are the limits in total probability? Minus infinity to plus infinity. Why? Because you are here the molecules are having all the velocities starting from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. Here, I am making use of one formula. What is that? Probability of integral minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus b x square dx is equal to root pi by b. Remember this formula. I am using this formula here 3 times. Why? Because we are having 3 exponential functions and 3 integrals. So for the integration of each exponential function, you have to put pi by b. Okay, a cube is already there. Okay, for this integration you have to put 1 root pi by b. For the second integration of this function, you have to put again another root pi by b. Again for the integration of this e power minus b omega square, now w square function, again you are going to get the answer as e power root pi b. Why? Because in all the exponential functions variables are different but constant is same. That's why here you are getting the same constant in the integration of each and every exponential function, isn't it? Now I am erasing this thing. This is equal to how much you are having from the probability? 1. This entire thing is equal to, on the RHS side, you are having 1. See, now this will give you the values for A and B. Okay. Now, A cube into how much? 3 times, 3 root pi by b's are there. That means root pi by b cube. That means what is the meaning of this? Root pi by b cube means pi by b whole to the power of 3 by 2. This is equal to 1, isn't it? I am writing, I am expressing root as a exponential. Again, 3 is there, square cube is there. So you are getting 3 by 2 instead of 1 by 2. Now, what is your a cube value? Tell me. 1 by pi by b, isn't it? 1 by pi by b to the power of 3 by 2. That means you have to reverse the fraction. B by pi, 3 by 2. Okay. So, a cube is equal to b by pi whole to the power of 3 by 2. Now, you may cancel cube, cube. So, what will be your A now? A is simply b by pi 1 by 2 power 1 by 2. So, root b by pi. So, what is the value of A? Root b by pi. Okay. Now, we got the value of A. But actually, what's the value of this B is? Actually, the value of B is, in terms of molecular properties, B is given by m by 2kT. Okay, here I am writing. Since B is equal to root, just B is equal to m by 2kT. Okay. You may derive this later. Okay. This gives you A is equal to B by pi 1 by 2 na power. B means m by 2kT. Pi is already there in the denominator. So, what will be the value of A? 2 pi m by 2 pi kT or kBT whole to the power of 1 by 2 by making use of this formula. Here I am substituting. Here in the last equation, I am substituting the B value as m by 2kT. M is the mass of the gas molecule. K is the Boltzmann constant. T is the absolute temperature. So, now we have the value for A in terms of molecular properties. Molecular parameters. M is the mass. K is the Boltzmann constant. T is the absolute temperature. Okay. Right. So, now we have both A and B values. So, you know the expression for the total probability. Okay, now let us try to write the expression for the total probability with these A and B values, with these A and B values. Okay. I will just go on writing on a white paper all these things because I am very quickly erasing all these things. Because I do not have that much space here. See, again, you recall the previous equation. What was the previous equation? Yeah, P is equal to A. What is that? A cube, na? A cube e power minus b common. U square plus B square plus W square into du dv dw. Okay, this was our previous expression. Now, I want to put these A and B values in this equation. Then, what you are going to get here? Okay, what you are going to get here? What is A? Put A value here. This is equal to m by 2 pi kT. M by 2 pi kT whole to the power a value. This is 1 by 2, but already 3 is there. Already 3 is there. So here instead of 1 by 2, you are going to get 3 by 2 a cube into how much you are having? E power minus b is there. E power minus b is there. What is b? M by (2KT). Okay, we are almost running out of time. Okay, let us continue our derivation until the session is terminated. Yeah, e power minus b means minus m by 2KT into u square plus v square plus w square into du dv dw. Okay, this is what the expression for the probability. Okay, now suppose that total number of molecules are n. Okay, out of those n molecules, only dn molecules are in this velocity ranges u2, u plus du, v2, v plus dv, w2, w plus dw. Then how do you write the probability? Come on, tell me. Favorable incidents are, what is the formula for probability? Come on, tell me, anyone from your class. What is the formula or the definition of the probability? Probability is equal to, is a fraction, no? Number of favorable incidents by total incidents, or the number of favorable events by total events. Here the favorable molecules are dn. Only this fraction of molecules are in that velocity range. Total molecules are n. So p is given by dn by n. So here in the place of p, now you may write dn by n. Here only I am writing we are almost very near to the final equation. Dn by n is equal to this much. Then what will be your n? Come on, tell me. What will be your n? Dn. Now you take this n to this side. Then what happens? Here only I am modifying c. Dn is equal to n into, dn is equal to n into m by 2 pi kt whole to the power of 3 by 2 into e power minus m by 2 kt into u square plus v square plus w square into du dv dw. See, this equation is looking very lengthy, but it is very easy to derive this equation. Okay, you need not to be frightened by taking the, by seeing the length of this equation. Why? Because we are taking three axes. So we are writing the probability of finding the molecule along each and every axis. That's why our equation is becoming very lengthy. If you take the motion along only one axis, then the things look very simple. Okay, now this is what we call as the Maxwell's distribution law. See, you see this equation, we call this equation itself as the Maxwell's. Now our derivation is almost completed. Yeah, what is this? This is called Maxwell's speed distribution. So what is this? This is what the Maxwell's speed distribution law. See, the speeds are distributed among various molecules in the gas in such a manner. Okay, the speed distribution conform to certain law. called as a Maxwell's speed distribution law. Maxwell's speed distribution law. Okay, here you may write it in a somewhat compact form. Okay, somewhat short form compared to this form. For that, what you have to do is you have to eliminate. You have to find what is du, dv, dw. We found what is fu, fv, fw, but we left this product as it is, du, dv, dw. Well, actually, here, whenever you take any gas, okay, the volume itself show you how many number of molecules are inside of that volume. So, we take this volume as a measurement for, for the number of molecules inside of that. Okay. Here the volume element is velocity volume element. Okay, velocity volume element. So here all the molecules whose velocities are in between C and C plus DC, why? Because total velocity is C, okay, will be found between the two concentric circles C now you are taking two circles, say this circle is having C radius, the sphere is having C plus DC radius. See, you are now you have to find the volume between these two spheres. Why? Because molecules having such velocities are always found in between these two shells. Okay. Then what is the volume of this shell? See, volume of this bigger shell minus volume of this smaller shell will give you the volume of this area. So you may replace in the place of du, dv, dw this volume. Okay, how to do the volume of the bigger circle, bigger sphere minus smaller sphere. Tell me the value of the volume formula for the volume of the sphere of radius r. Anyone from your class? What is the formula for the volume of a sphere with radius r? All of you know that, na? V is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, here the radius, you want volume difference, na? For the bigger sphere, it is C plus DC. For smaller sphere, it is C. Okay. So, volume difference will be, here, one radius is C plus DC. This is the, now this will give you the volume of bigger sphere. For the volume of small sphere, what you have to do? You have to write 4 by 3 pi. Simply, smaller sphere radius is C, that's why you are having 4 pi C cube. Now, here you apply the formula for A plus B whole cube. What is the formula for A plus B whole cube? See, you have to apply all these things. What is that? Right. Now, after expanding like that, by using that formula, now you are going to find this different to be. See, here you are going to get your A is C, B is DC. Okay. See, A cube, A cube. See, here, this cube term will be cancelled. So, you are only left with, DC cube terms. Okay. But DC is a small value. Cube of that will be very small value. So, I am neglecting DC cube as well. So, now, you are left with only one cross term, 4 by 3 pi into 3 a square b, 3 c square dc, 3 cancel. So, what you are going to get here, 4 pi c square dc.